Welcome to Biz Roanoke. Today we are at Big Lick Comics and we are here with J.D. Sutphin, who is the co-owner of this fabulous establishment located in Northeast Roanoke. Hi, J.D.
Hello, thanks for having us.
Thank you for allowing us to come into your business today and talk to you a little bit and learn more about it.
Thank you.
So you have opened during the COVID-19 pandemic.
Yeah.
Along with your brother, Adam.
Yes, ma'am.
Tell us how all this got started.
Well, actually, you know, it was during that shutdown. It's something that we had been talking about for years. We were raised in the antique business, which is very kind of similar, you know, with collectibles and stuff like that here in the comic shop with my grandfather's store, Jeans Trading Post. But during the shutdown, you know, there was a lot of times that I wasn't putting on events. I wasn't doing the things I would normally do. Neither was my brother. And we started talking about what did we want to do, you know? What's really like a quality of life kind of thing? And what could we do that's going to be something that's for our kids, but also still, we knew that the COVID thing is going to end at some point. What do we do that we could engage with the community? What better than engaging with someone than through creative means?
Right.
And we're literally celebrating creativity 5 days a week here.
And it's very creative. It's like going into a mini Disney World,
yes,
as you would say.
Or, absolutely.
And I know that you're a big fan of Walt Disney.
Absolutely.
Yes. So talk to us about the different title. You have like comic books, lots and lots of comic books. How many different, I guess,
there's thousands and thousands of comics actually in the store, but what's really cool is we're really pushing the new comics as well. I love how many times I've heard someone come into the store and say, this is the first comic book I've ever bought.
Wow.
It makes the hair on the back of my neck stand up, whether that person is 12 or 48. So we have 140 new titles a month that we carry here along our giant wall that we call the Halls of All Knowing. That's a fun comic geek reference. But then we also have thousands and thousands of back issues. So everything back from the 30s and 40s all the way up until today. So you might be looking for something for your collection, or you might want to start really early with Spider-Man in 1977 and work your way up to right now. You can do that here.
So you've really created a destination business. I know you've had travelers coming in from lots of different places.
Yeah.
Tell us about that a little bit.
That's been the really amazing thing that, you know, social media is just incredible when people are sharing their experience in a place like this. And we've had other comic book store owners come from Delaware, from Philadelphia, come down here to see. And, you know, because this is definitely a niche kind of thing. And, you know, we really try to promote the fact that we were doing something that was an immersive experience. And the response has just been awesome, because this is something that you get really passionate about these characters. You know, I still think about the Superman books that I read when I was a kid, and they still get me excited. And to see people, you know, share that either with their kids or just it sparking that memory that they had from when they were 12 or 13 years old, it travels long distances. And it's really neat to see them travel here to see us.
And when did you all open the store?
So it was Saturday, April the 3rd.
Okay, and we're getting ready. We're gearing up to do your grand opening and ribbon cutting.
Yes.
I know that when I was here talking to you previously, you had talked about, you had kind of depicted Roanoke and some of the creativity around the store. Talk to our viewers about that a little bit.
Well, so, you know, I love the term Big Lick. I love that name. It's in my other company, Big Lick Entertainment. Right. I like the idea of taking a step back in order to go forward. Mm-hmm. But then we were thinking about, what if there was actually a story within the store? So our whole tagline is not a store, a story. So the idea is, when you're in Big Lick, you are in the town of Big Lick. And it's a multiverse. I'm going real deep here on some geek stuff. And you are actually in different lands, just like you'd be like in Disney World.
Wonderful.
When you go into Disney, you do not see the outside world. You are inside Disney. You are there purely to be happy. That's the whole idea when you're here. Whether you're in Action Figure Land or Excelsior Park, which is our kids and creative zone, inspired by Stan Lee. It's something that when you feel like you're in here, you're just totally escaping from everything going on and just celebrating all the fun stuff that's inside.
So if anyone wants an escape, this is the place to come.
100%. That's why we added even, you know, some food and beverage over in the front area, because, you know, we want you to stay here as long as you want. We have people that come in and pick up their stack of a dozen new comic books. They go directly over to our With Great Coffee area with H&C Coffee, another awesome Roanoke brand.
Yes.
And they'll sit there for 2 hours reading their book, having a cup of coffee. And it's like, that's exactly what you should be doing right now. Take that break and de-stress inside Big Lick Comics.
We've talked about this a little bit, but how do you feel like this business impacts economic development in the city of Roanoke?
Oh, it's huge, because I'm a huge proponent of seeing how we're all truly in that economic community together. Mm-hmm. And our great guy down here at Bratcher's, Right. You know, seeing him sell out of hot dogs on a day that we've got like a Star Wars day going right. on.
And Bratcher's is an ice cream shop.
Ice cream shop yes. in the same shopping right. center. To see the pizza place that's getting ready to reopen. And just honestly, just one of the things of like walking outside of the shop for a minute and having great conversations with the other business owners
right.
and talking about things that we could do in the parking lot together. That stuff is unbelievable. And it mm-hmm. only happens when you're out and in person with other people. And to see all that coming back now through COVID because of our medical industry, the first responders, businesses that have had to think about other 180 directions to stay
right.
in business.
Oh, yeah.
I had to do that myself.
Sure.
It's absolutely incredible. And I think that we're going to see a renaissance in retail, a renaissance in restaurants, a renaissance in business growth, because that positivity has been brewing for a long time,
yes.
even prior to COVID.
Yes.
And people are now getting that age too. I see so many people wanting to quit their job and start something for themselves. And if they're stressed about that job, now is the time to do it.
Exactly.
Now's the time. There are banks that are going to support you. There are cities that are going to support you.
Exactly.
And it's just nothing like it. I mean, to see my son walk through the door and know that, you know, his dad likes what he does for a living, that's a big lesson.
That's a huge lesson. Yeah. That's very, so much gratification.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Makes me emotional just talking about
yes,
it.
Yes, yes. Well, I appreciate what you've done here. You and Adam have
Thank
done
you.
Here.
Yeah.
It's wonderful. You've created a vibrancy in this.
Thank you.
This center along 460 East or Orange Avenue corridor.
It's like Botetourt Light.
Yeah, yeah.
It's
exactly.
Diet Botetourt.
It's
really close.
City, but it's still
exactly.
city. Yes. And we look forward to hearing more and more about what's going on here and learning about your events that you're doing
Thank you.
Here because
yeah.
I think there's some good things coming down the pike.
Absolutely. And we want to see, you know, what we can do that's also working with other businesses. One thing that's been truly amazing is seeing the other comic store and like geek store owners that
right.
have been in here with us, folks, that we wouldn't be in existence if we were not buying comic books from Terry at B&D Comics.
Yes.
And when
yes.
we're sharing and sending other customers to each other, that's what Roanoke's about. Roanoke's very, very different in that type of community that we all want to see each other just continue to rise.
Right, right. Well, thank you for joining us
thank
today.
You.
And we'll look forward to hearing more great stories.
Thanks so much.
One, two, three.
Big Comics.
If you have questions about Big Lick Comics, please give me a call at the City of Roanoke Department of Economic Development. You can reach me by email at lisa.soltis@roanokeba.gov or by telephone at 540-853-1694. Thank you.